Let's talk about the signs themselves. Okay, so Aries is known as Mesha, Mesha Rashi, and this is a Sanskrit term. It's basically the ram. Let's see if I have a picture of it. Here is the ram. So this is the part of the Kala Purusha, the cosmic man that rules the head, right? Have you heard of that term, headstrong? That's very much an Aries term. The reason that is because it's a fire sign. So there's a lot of inspiration and instinct and a lot of that drive and energy to like kind of consume and move through things quickly. Just as fire operates in the world, this is how this sign operates, very fiery. It's ruled by a planet, it's ruled by Mars. And Mars has this kind of martial, Mars is martial energy about it. It's very serious, it's very direct, it goes after what it wants. So there's a way that in which it operates, this planet. So the planet has a lot to do with the way that the sign's characteristics are developed. It's a male energy, so we have like alternate male, female, and there's six male signs, six female signs. So one is more outward and one oriented, and the other is more inward oriented. Again, it's the ram, so it's cardinal fire. It's the beginning of the zodiac. We talk about these people kind of like having a strong intellect because again, it rules the mind. So they can be independent, forceful, very strong-willed. They are very self-expressive because of the fire nature as well. And there's a list of qualities that I've put here: dynamic, aggressive, initiative, competitive. A lot of these come from fire. A lot of these come from the fact that it's ruled by Mars. A lot of it's that it's male. So it's kind of a blend of this. Let's see. There's like a higher evolution of this, or a higher expression of this sign as well. They can be very good leaders. They can be bold leaders. They can be courageous. The less evolved or less mature elements of Aries is that they could be pushy, they could be angry, a little bit imposing, or just sort of, instead of assertive, they could be aggressive. So it's kind of like, depends on how well functional these signs are in people's charts. So that's Mesha. Vrishabha is Taurus Rashi. It's a Vrishabha Rashi is Taurus, it's the bull. And we have a different element here as an earth sign. So earth is slow moving. If you think about like things moving over time, like plate tectonics or sort of mountains, how long it takes for things to erode. Like earth is just a slow moving energy. So there is this kind of consistent, practical, grounded nature of earth, okay? It's ruled by Venus, the planet Venus. So they're very sensual, cordial. They like to maintain harmony in social relations. So basically it talks about the neck of the person and the face of the person. The first thing that you notice about a person is their face. This shows the beauty or the attractiveness. It also has all of the elements of your eyes, like the senses, basically. That's why it's sensual. Take in sensory information, right? So that's why this sign is all about kind of experiencing life, and it's very tactile because it's earth. It's not conceptual. So these people like partnerships, they like relationships, they do well with art, beauty, fashion, all these kind of more materialistic type things. The more negative traits of this would be that they're a little bit more possessive, or they could be a little bit fixed in their ways. I don't know how, I can kind of skip over some of the core, other characteristics, just to get kind of the core stuff since we're going through all of the 12 signs. But this is the Taurus bull. Gemini is the third sign of the zodiac. It's an air sign. So we've gone from fire to earth, now we're at air. So air is always about the intellect, and they're about fairness and justice and communication. So it's a communicative sign. This sign is ruled by the planet Mercury. So Mercury is all about, Mercury is the planet that's closest to the sun, actually. It's the closest to the king. So it's kind of the minister where it does a lot of the back and forth, kind of, it's the messenger. It goes from the king to the common people. And it's kind of like about the news and media and business to get things from industry to the people. So it's sort of the mediator, back and forth energy. And its symbol is a couple, actually. So this is another difference between, if you're familiar with Western astrology, Gemini is considered to be the twins, right? But actually, in ancient astrology, they are the couple. It's all about relationship. Now, you need relationship in your personal life, you need relationship in business, you know, so this is important for having that kind of interplay. It talks about mutable air. So mutable, what is mutable? Mutable is something that moves. It goes back and forth, right? And air is like a gust of wind. So they can be very like light on their feet and constantly kind of doing a lot of things. They like to dabble in a lot of different areas of life. They may be very curious because of that like air element about them. And also Mercury is about information. So these, like, Mercury is kind of like the person who likes fun, quick jokes. They like the punchline. They're very kind of quick-witted, light on their feet, okay? Let's see. The lower aspects of this is that they may become bored easily or like easily agitated, and they can have an excessive amount of thinking or just being a little bit fickle too. Because it's like the mind, right? Okay. Let's move to the fourth sign of the zodiac. So Cancer is the fourth sign. It's actually a Karka Rashi or Kataka Rashi. So this is symbolized by a crab. This is what it looks like here. It's got a hard shell and it's soft in the middle, kind of like the qualities of this type of person that was born under Cancer element, is that they tend to be a little bit protective, especially of family, especially of friends. You could kind of even think of it like protective family could even be as extreme as like mafia. It's like we're our family. But it also could just be that they're quite interesting also because they, I went too far. It's ruled by the moon, which is also very sensitive. So they're not Mars ruled. Mars would be very forthright, again, that martial energy of like, I'm protective, I'm gonna defend, but they're kind of, they go about things kind of indirectly. If you think of how a crab moves, it kind of moves to this way, can kind of go around like a block in front of it. So they sidestep confrontation, but they always end up being able to defend themselves because they have those pinchers, right? Anyway, the qualities of the animal, the zoo of the sky, the zodiac, really comes through with these signs. So it is a water sign. So we went from fire to earth to air. Now we're at water. So water is very flowing, it's very sensitive, it's reflective. If you think about a pool of water and you can see a reflection in it, it's very dreamy, it kind of goes with the flow in life. It's a very subjective and feeling course that through life. We talked about it being the chest of the cosmic being. So this is the heart, right? Home is where the heart is. It's also the fourth sign, which is representative of like mother and home and all of that. Four is a number of like stability. If you think like four walls of a home, it's where you can dwell and have that security. They make great hosts. These people are all about connecting with people on an emotional and personal level. They like to have people in their home. They can be shy and independent, but they also can be a little bit popular. Just people like people, they like Cancers because they're ruled by the moon. The moon is your mood. So they can really kind of control the mood of the room sometimes. So the fifth sign of the zodiac is us going back now to a fire sign. So we've gone fire, earth, air, water. Now we're back repeating the cycle again. It's going to go fire, air, or fire, earth, air, water again, and then we'll have a third part of that as well. So Leah is Simha Rashi. Simha means lion, and it's a fire sign. It's ruled by the sun. They're very powerful people. They can have an influential course in life. If you think about the sun, it basically brings life to the world, right? It makes plants grow. So without the sun, we wouldn't have anything, really. It's the center of the solar system. So this can talk about leadership, government, politics, people who have some sort of authority, and it can even be on a small scale. If someone just has a very kind of confident or domineering even type personality within their personal life, but they tend to be very warm, just like the sun gives warmth, right? It's a male sign, it's represented by the lion, it's fixed fire, so they're very, like, have that sort of nobility or like that heart of a lion. I also have heard, like, in war or in battle, people getting like a honor of like a purple heart. Purple is the color of royalty, and the heart is the heart of the lion, that bravery, that courage, right? To fight in battle, right? What are you doing? You're protecting and defending your country or your nationality. So it's all about creation, right? The sun gives creation, so it's all about self-expression, creativity, they love attention. The more balanced Leos can tend to be humble. You think about humility and service. So when you think of a king, their job is not there to sit and eat grapes and be fanned all day. They have things to do for the people. They are working for the people. That's a true democracy. That's actually true, balanced, healthy leadership. It's not about the sun pulling in energy from everyone else to feed its ego. It's all about giving light. So there's a lot of humility and service that can be seen with Leo. So it's all about pride. If it's controlled, then they can go to great heights. There's the lion. So Virgo is the next Rashi. It's called Kanya Rashi. And it is a maiden or an unmarried girl, or otherwise known as a virgin. Virgin is someone who's just unmarried in the past. We're moving back into that cycle of the elements, so now we're back into earth sign. But instead of earth sign rule by Venus, which is all about love and beauty and aesthetics and all of that, it's ruled by Mercury. So we have a different blend here. We've got earth, much like Taurus, but we have Mercury, which brings in that mercurial energy. Mercury is the merchant. So a lot of these words, you know, they interplay. So it's basically something that's unaltered. It's something in its natural unaltered state. Or it's, if you think about, like, people talk about virgin hair, it's undyed. It's untampered with. If you think about crops that are just taken from the earth and they're not processed, right? That natural state of being, that's very much Virgo. Virgo represents the earth, and again, because it's an earth sign, and it's crops. What comes after the sun? The sun sign Leo, it grows crops. Then what do you do with it? You have the harvest, right? So you pick what nature is giving you, and you are basically collecting and then sorting what you can keep, what you can't keep. And that's very much about Virgo, because it also rules, if you go back to the Kala Purusha, the cosmic man, it rules the intestines. What food can you use? What can you not use? What can you break down? What is unnecessary? So it's all about utility, which is also another kind of quality of an earth sign. It's very practical, useful. Those are some of the qualities that come through with the Virgo personality, is about, sorting, usefulness, organization, all of that.